So many good questions that are coming in. And we just have 5 minutes left with Dr. Wen here. And we are getting, as I mentioned, a lot of questions about the boosters. Could you just give us an overview of your sense of, do you believe that the evidence is clear enough that there is a rationale for the boosters, that there does seem to be some data indicating that the vaccines do wane in their effectiveness at preventing infection at a certain month-long period post-inoculation? Do you think the evidence is there? Does it make sense? Do you understand what the government is doing here?
Yeah, so I would say we first have to distinguish between the announcement last week on immunocompromised individuals and the announcement today. So last week, people who are immunocompromised, in a sense, they're not really getting a booster. They never responded very well to the vaccines. And so we're trying to increase their immune protection as much as possible. I think there's not much controversy about that. The announcement today is saying that it looks like the effectiveness of the vaccines might be waning over time, especially with the Delta variant, when it comes to symptomatic disease, as in the vaccines still protect you very well against hospitalization, severe illness, and death. But it looks like there is decreased effectiveness over time when it comes to preventing you from getting COVID. Now, I think that I am in support of this booster strategy. I've actually been asking for weeks why we are so far behind Israel, the UK, and Germany that have already started doing boosters. I think at this point, we should be presenting people with a choice. There are going to be some people who will say, look, I don't really want to get a booster. I am fine. Now that I know that I'm protected against severe illness, I'm going to go back to many of my pre-pandemic activities. I don't mind if I get flu-like symptoms. Everybody who lives with me at home is also vaccinated. I'm fine with the protection that I have at the moment. On the other hand, there are going to be other people who say, I have chronic medical conditions. I am elderly. If I were to get even a mild cold, that might land me in the hospital, in which case I really want to get a booster. If my immunity is decreasing, let's say from 90% to 60%, I want that 90% protection, and so I'm going to get a booster. So I actually think that leaving the option open to people to choose whether a booster is appropriate, I think that's the best course of action. That's not exactly what the Biden administration has said, although they are telegraphing, I think, that that people are going to have the option to start receiving the booster in September, as long as they are 8 months out from their initial vaccination.